Today we're going to talk about the Hall Effect Sensor. This is a sensor that we're going to use for an end step for both X and Y. So I'm going to review a couple of things real quick here about our sensor ports. We have three pins. The first pin is signal, the second pin is negative, and the last pin is positive. This is our X min, this is our X max, this is our Y min, this is our Y max, this is our Z min, and this is our Z max. So in a moment, I'll show you this sensor and how it's configured. Okay, this is the Hall Effect sensor that we're gonna use. I'm gonna point out the pins because it's kind of hard to see. The first pin is the voltage pin. The second pin is the ground. And the last pin is the signal pin. Over on this side of the Hall Effect sensor, we have one side that detects the magnetic field, and on the other side we have it as well. But in front it won't, so you can only approach from here and here. So I'm going to show you how it works. There's a magnet down here. And what we're going to do is the magnet, as it approaches, will trip the sensor. The same thing goes for the other side if you were to come from this side. So in a moment, I'll show you how to connect it to the board and use it. Okay, in order to connect it, what we're going to do is we're going to put this red female pin on the voltage. We're going to put the black on the ground. And we're going to put the green on the signal. In a second, I'll show you how to connect it to the board. Okay, we have the RAMPS board here, so we're going to connect it first to the signal pin for X min. Then we're going to connect the ground, which is the middle pin. Then we're going to connect the voltage pin, which is the bottom pin in the X-min row. And in a moment, I'll show you how to program it in Marlin. Okay, before we can program it, we need to connect the USB serial cable. So what we're going to do is we're going to connect the big end of the board, and we're going to connect the small end to the computer. And you're going to hear a beep. Now keep in mind, once this is energized, you don't want to touch it. So in a second, I'll show you how to program it in Marlin. Okay, we're going to open up the Marlin 1.1.8 folder. We're going to open up the Marlin subfolder. We're going to press M on the keyboard, scroll down to marlin.ino and press enter. We're going to select the configuration.h tab. We're going to do a find on use underscore xmin underscore plug. And as we can see, it's uncommented, so we're good there. So we're going to scroll down to inverting. So what we want to do is we want to do x underscore min underscore end stop underscore inverting. We want to change the false to a true. And save that. We want to check to see that we have a port selected, which we do, and that the Arduino Mega 2560 is selected for the architecture of the actual chipset we're using. And what we're going to do is compile and upload. So we're going to press this. Okay, before we start testing with Pronterface, I want to show you how the sensor works. If we move the magnet, which I placed under here, up next to the Hall Effect sensor, the green light will turn to red, and if I move it away, it'll turn back to green. So in a moment, in Pronterface, I'll show you how it works. Okay, we're going to open up Pronterface.exe. We're going to connect to the printer. And now what we're going to do is we're going to check the state of the actual end stop before we actually move the magnet nearby. So in order to do that, we have to type M119 and press enter. And right now it says that the X-Min is open. So the next thing we want to do is move the magnet next to the Hall effect sensor and see what happens. Okay, I'm moving the magnet closed. Now it's actuated, so it's actually red for the LED. So we're gonna go back into Pronterface and do M119 again. And now it says triggered. So let's move it away and see what happens. Okay, in Pronterface, we're going to press M119 again and see what happens. And now it says open. So if you liked my video, please press the like button and subscribe, and thank you for your time.